One, two, three.
Sorry. Move from start and switch places with an opponent.
I used to think, like, when will I feel better, or is that, like, something I'm doing wrong?
So he has eosinophilic esophagitis, as well as some other allergic kind of diseases. It takes a while to get to a diagnosis, kind of understand what's going on, and then get them feeling better.
It was because of what I was eating that was making me feel bad.
It is so overwhelming at first. It's overwhelming to hear that your child has this disease and not many people know what it is.
Our Center for Eosinophilic Disease is one of the oldest really in the world. What we offer here is a chance to get a integrated treatment plan with good communication amongst all the team members. You see multiple disciplines. We try to treat the whole patient and we try to not make treatment decisions in isolation. So I think that's probably the biggest advantage that we have, is that the communication between the partners in the center is seamless, and the communication back to the family, therefore, is the same voice.
One of the things that I find most valuable about working in a multidisciplinary center like the CCED is that we're able to take care of the whole child. And the role of behavioral medicine and clinical psychology within that is really assessing how patients are doing and how families are doing in their lives.
Catch me up since last time.
I went to a camp this weekend.
Oh, that's awesome. We were able to connect over my very minimal knowledge of soccer, but just also creating a space where Joe could talk about some of the things and his family could talk about some of the things that were challenging just day to day.
I think the best part of her being part of the team is that she already knew what EoE was. She related to being able to talk about the disease and what it meant and what he was feeling. EoE is not going away, but we have gotten to the point that it's just part of our lives now. There are still days that it's overwhelming, but he's doing so great and we've gotten here, and it's so great that he's doing so well. Joe's thriving with it, which I think is the difference.
I don't think that he sees limits anymore. I think maybe when he started, he saw limits related to eosinophilic disorder and his food allergies. And I think now, I guess the sky's the limit, whatever he decides is next.
And one of our goals with having an integrated center is to not feel like, oh, I'm just going to see GI today, so all I'm going to talk about is from here to here, is that we are very much integrated.
This disease isn't going away anytime soon. You just have to learn to live with it. You have to find the positives in it. I mean, sure, there's lots of negatives, but you shouldn't focus on that. You have to think what's good about it. You have to find the good things in it.
I don't know where we would be without the Eosinophilic Center. I mean, he has made so much progress, and he's doing so well. I'm just so thankful that it's an option for us.
It was great seeing you both. Take care, and I'll see you next time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.